53 leaders, representing a quarter of the world's population, all given a very Aussie welcome. But in a room full of very powerful people, there was just one star.
I wish heads of government well in agreeing further reforms that respond boldly to the aspirations of today and that keep the Commonwealth fresh and fit for tomorrow.
The leaders are under pressure to adopt reforms to establish the relevance of the Commonwealth as an institution. An eminent persons report compiled after the last CHOGM also calls for the Commonwealth to set up an independent watchdog to monitor member countries like Sri Lanka accused of human rights abuses. That's been shot down, though, with most countries from Africa and the subcontinent opposed. Instead, a ministerial action group will be given more power to intervene before human rights issues worsen.
This is an important set of reform proposals emanating from the Commonwealth Ministerial Action Group about strengthening their own role and giving them the ability to get involved when a country is, you know, veering off course rather than waiting for a country to have gone over the cliff.
The global economy and climate change are also on the agenda, along with a focus on empowering women in developing countries. The British Prime Minister, David Cameron, is pushing for equality to be extended to the royal family, calling for changes which would see the firstborn child, boy or girl, inherit the throne.
I wish for this meeting that we each give our best to achieve the best outcome for all of our nations.